Hey there, what's up? I'm Brett, and today we are discussing some of the more tricky and difficult radical problems you might run into. So one type of tricky radical that you might run into is trying to multiply radicals together that have different indices. Now, so long as those radicals have the same base, we can actually perform this operation. Now to do that, it might be helpful to change it out into that rational exponent form I've talked about before. And what that's gonna do is just make it a lot clearer how to proceed. So my first step is to trade out the cube root of 3 for 3 to the 1/3 power, and the fourth root of 3 as 3 to the 1/4 power. Now from here you can see that we have two values being multiplied together and they have the same base but different exponents. Our rule here is simply to multiply these together, I can add the exponents. So this problem really boils down to 3 to the 1/3 plus 1/4. I'll go ahead and make a common denominator of 12 and add those together. Lastly, we can go ahead and rewrite this back into radical notation. I'll go ahead and get rid of the 12 here and replace it with a 12th root. So in the last problem, I said that in order to multiply radicals with different indices, we had to have the same number underneath the radical. And here on the second problem, I'm going to show you how you can sometimes get away with having different numbers under the radical, as long as you're a little clever and the numbers work out nicely. So again, just like in the last step, I'm going to start with replacing the fifth root and fourth roots with their rational exponent equivalents. And here's where the trick comes in. I can go ahead and write 4 as 2 squared. And by doing that, I have managed to make a base of 2 on both of these. All right, so now I have a problem that looks a lot like the problem up above. And all I need to do here is add the exponents. There we go, and just to clean it up a bit, I'm going to write it back in radical notation, which will be the 10th root of 2 to the 7th. Another sort of tricky thing you might see is nested radicals. And again, this is why knowing the fraction notation is so important, because in radical notation, it's just completely unclear how you would handle this. So let's start by trading it out for the alternate notation. There, I just replaced the square root with a 1/2 power and the cube root with a 1/3 power. Now, according to our exponent rules, this 1/2 power will get applied to both the 8 and the 2 to the 1/3. Remember that when we raise a power to a power, we multiply. So this becomes 2 to the 1/6 power. And again, like in the last problem, we can do a little bit of clever math by replacing the 8 with 2 cubed. Now all I need to do is add the exponents to multiply these together. Doing that, I get 2 to the 9/6 times 2 to the 1/6, which is 2 to the 10/6. And of course, 10/6 can be reduced down to 5/3, so I'm just going to do that. And then the last step here is just to do a little bit of simplification. The way I like to handle this type of problem is to go ahead and take the improper fraction and rewrite it as a mixed number. So this becomes 2 to the 1 2/3. And then I can go ahead and split this up into two separate bases. Lastly, all I need to do is reintroduce that radical notation. So I'll go ahead and introduce a cube root here. There we go. Now we have simplified it down to 2 times the cube root of 4. Do you have a problem involving radicals that I haven't talked about yet? Let me know what it is in the comments below. And while you're there, help me out by hitting that subscribe button and giving this video a big thumbs up. Thanks, guys. See you next time.